Hi, I'm Travis.
I'm Cameron.
And we're from Austin, Texas, smoking a joint with the marijuana man, and you're watching Pot TV.
That's right.
Well, here we are in the Vapor Lounge at the BC Marijuana Party Bookstore, and it is my distinct pleasure to welcome Mr. Mel Frank to the show. Welcome.
Good to see you.
Thanks for being here.
Glad you invited me, Greg.
So, as many of you know out there, and maybe some of you who don't, Mel is responsible for a great number.
And how many books, actually? How many titles?
Well, three books that I've authored and a few that I've published.
All right. But these are some of the... Mel is responsible for some of the very first publications on how to grow marijuana and researching marijuana really from a pot smoker's point of view rather than a prohibitionist point of view.
Absolutely, right.
But he's certainly responsible for many, many growers out there in the world, and I, on behalf of all of them, would like to say thanks for doing that.
Well, thank you.
Now, obviously, we should start at the beginning. And how did you ever get started?
I just
started?
Wanted to say it was four people who wanted to grow that the books were written, really.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
Yes, of course it is.
That was completely what it was about.
Bud, you got smoking pot when?
I started smoking pot after I got out of the service. I was in the Navy. And in 1967, I finished my tour of duty. And in January of 68, I smoked my first pot. And I think I started growing probably about March of that year.
Is that right?
Yes. Because I fell in love with pot as soon as I smoked it.
So it was inspiration rather than desperation?
Well, no. Although pot was like, you know, $15 a lid then, which was a little less than an ounce, but it was also either very poor Mexican grade grass, which was maybe about 1% THC, 1 to 2% THC, or with some leaf that was brought in from California, right? Which was a little bit better, but the leaf was actually a little bit better.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Leaf coming from California.
Yeah.
You were in New York.
I was in New York City, and what I noticed right away when I got started buying Mexican lids was that more than half of the weight was seeds. And my apartment, I had a huge apartment in New York City, seven rooms that I just lucked into, totally naive about finding apartments in New York, but I had it for next to nothing. And I filled it with houseplants. I had well over 100 houseplants after a while. And some of them I grew under lights. So it was natural for me to start saying, hey, let's see what I can do with marijuana.
Here's a seed, let's see.
And I started growing it and noticed that this thing could really grow the more light you gave it. And eventually I just devoted a room to it. Hung up some fluorescents, added some incandescents later as the plants got really big. Had the things on pulleys, raising it up. And grew it well into the summer. I was wondering why my plants aren't flowering. And then the brilliant idea came to me that maybe they think it's an endless summer here and they're never going to flower. So I turned down the lights to, I think it was about 14 hours, and I started to get some flowering. The males all flowered. The females started to flower. I turned it down a little more, and boom, I had buds. And later on, when I went to college, I found out about the photo period and all that. But I actually discovered that really just on a fluke.
So, as I mentioned to Mel earlier, I said that there's 1 million of us out there who did this trial and error before we read his book, and here he was doing it before he wrote his book. So you're growing some pot and having what kind of success? These were obviously sativa seeds that you were growing from Mexico?
Everything was sativa, yes. Everything was, no, Colombia also.
Colombian Mexican,
right. Colombian and Mexican, it you know, and I was growing the plants large then. I mean, they must have been 5 or 6, about 5 feet, I think.
Indoor?
Indoor, yeah.
Now, obviously, you're using fluorescent lights, which right. we know aren't all that strong.
Right.
You must have had a lot of those.
I had a lot of those. I think my first ones, well, I used 8-footers. And I think I had, I'm sorry, that was my second crop, was 8-footers. At first, I started with 4-footers.
Right.
You're right. And let's see, I must have had about 8 of those going. And then added the incandescents as they were getting bigger. Added floodlights at some point, all yeah. that stuff. And which I'm sure, you know.
I laugh because I went through all the
absolutely,
same things.
Absolutely, yeah.
Myself,
right.
as many
go through
did.
These things. So the next time, the next crop, I got a little more serious. And,
so
and had 6 8-footers.
So there you were growing pots. How did you get into writing about it?
I had worked a regular job during this time at the phone company. I was a technician. And at a certain point, I realized I am definitely not going to do this for the rest of my life, right? I just quit the job and spent a summer in Montauk running a youth hostel. And then came back to New York City that fall and was talking to a friend of mine who was a journalist, at that time a journalist, and since a retired journalist, and saying, well, I got to do something here, I got to make the rent. And he said, why don't you write something and we'll sell it as an article. And I said, I don't really know what to write about, which is what most people say. And he said, well, write what you know. And I said, well, I don't know anything. Well, he said, well, you think about something you do know. And I thought, well, maybe I'll write an article about pot. And he was totally encouraging and, helped edit it and everything. And because I had no training as a writer. I had, just a trade school, high school education. And eventually, I had the article and brought it down to Rolling Stone, the first and only place I brought it to. And it was published in the New York Flyer of the Rolling Stone as a two-part series.
And what year was this?
This was in 1970. Kara. The spring of 1970. And the editor called me to tell me that he was going to publish this article. And he said, what name do you want to use? And I hadn't thought of it. So I thought for a moment. I had two cats there with me, two Siamese cats, one named Melon and one named Frank. And I thought, Frank Melon, nope, I can't use that one. It's already been used, right? And I just said, Mel Frank, and that was it. So that's, I'm named after a couple of Siamese cats.
It's as simple as that. It sticks with you for the rest of your life.
There it is.
Well, it's funny.
So anyway, I also came to meet Ed Rosenthal, who we partnered on a number of things for a number of years.
Now, he had also submitted some articles to Rolling Stone.
He had submitted an article also at the same time. It wasn't quite the same. Mine was simply, how do you grow pot in your New York apartment?
Right.
And his was more of about him selling little homegrown kits, where he would set up the fluorescent lights, the pots, the whole thing, and show you how it was done. And
so then the editor put you together.
He said, you have to meet this guy. He wants to meet you. And Ed, after that, was just indomitable in terms of, like, we need to write a book, this and that, and just wouldn't let it go and just drove me crazy with this. But I mean, as it turned out, he changed both of our lives by his insistence.
Absolutely.
And I finally relented and took the article, added to it, produced more drawings, a few photographs, that sort of thing. He filled in some on outdoor, which I didn't have experience with. And
how long was this after the Rolling Stone encounter?
This is probably maybe a year later.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is probably in 1971 or something.
Okay.
Right? But he went and he shot that manuscript everywhere, eventually going to California, and it was published in 1974 by Level Press of San Francisco, and that was sold to another publisher called Andor Press The Indoor Press eventually became the publisher of the Marijuana Grower's Guide Deluxe, which was really sort of the seminal book on the subject.
Now, the first one, it had the longest title in the history of titles, doesn't it?
I had nothing to do with the title.
It was called the Indoor-Outdoor Highest Quality Marijuana Grower's Guide for
That's
you
it.
Aficionados out there.
That's it.
It wasn't just the Marijuana Grower's Guide.
It was the highest quality.
And it was indoor-outdoor.